about two other scenarios, and we're going to be going attacking the chokes when the guy comes up for side control, all right? One's going to be a Brabo choke, and the other one's going to be an arm and guillotine, but it's going to be a little bit modified, all right? And the modification you're going to see in a second, all right? So first we're going to discuss the Brabo choke, all right? When he comes, if I go for that guillotine, when he comes here, and I put my hand behind, this is a hard guillotine to finish. All right, when you have the arm on the inside like this, it's very hard to finish. It's not impossible to finish. You have to be, the other guy's gonna be a chud and he's gonna attack because he just doesn't like pressure on his neck at all. Or the person has a really, really good guillotine, okay? So generally, you don't wanna put your hand behind the tricep if his arm is stuck here. If my arm comes behind his tricep like this, what I wanna do is I wanna lift my hips up and pass his arm all the way through so that his arm isn't hooked on my back. All right, I want to lift my hips up, and what I do to ensure that is when he gets the underhook right here, I put one hand underneath here, my other hand goes to his wrist, and let's spin around so everyone can see. All there. So watch, when I'm over here and he gets this underhook, what I do is this hand goes to his wrist, and I feed to my other hand. So see how I have his hand, right? So I feed it. Now once I feed it, this hand is gonna tuck right underneath his elbow, and I'm gonna lean my head towards his hip. So I wanna get this sensitive, all right? Once this hand is deep, I can start locking up to my bicep. So let's just get here first. Okay, he's gonna come in starting in side control, he comes, frames, gets the underhook. When he does, I come underneath his neck, I lift my hips up, I grab his wrist, I feed to my other wrist. Here I can go back to my knees, get my balance, my hand goes underneath his tricep, nice and deep. I wanna make this arm long. And now this hand, my arm is gonna go over his head, and I'm gonna go grab my bicep. I'm gonna walk this hand all the way up to his back, all right? From here, what I wanna do is I wanna bring my hips back a little bit, getting on my toes, and now lean forward, right? Lean forward like this, and squeeze, all right? The reason why I like to keep my hips back a little bit is if I keep my hips like this once I'm locked up and he rolls over, he's gonna take me over. And then it is possible that I could finish the Brabo from the bottom if I have it locked in really tight, but I would much rather finish on top, okay? The thing is that you need to put your knees on the mat in order to get your arm deep. But once it's in deep and it's locked, kind of sprawl back a little bit, all right? So again, what we're gonna do is over here, I'm gonna start in side control, he comes underneath my neck, starts getting that underhook, gets on his side. Over his head, I keep my chest on his shoulder, lift my hips up, get on my toes, grab his wrist, and I feed. Now I go back to my knees, because I need that to help get my arm. This one's gonna shoot through, and I'm pushing my elbow down, I wanna tuck this in nice and tight. Once I'm here, I grab his head, I hook it like this, right? Hook on the back of his neck. This hand goes to my bicep, all right? And again, now I'm gonna bring my hips back, I can put my toes, bring it to the mat, and squeeze slowly until I get the tap, all right? So it's a really tight Brabo choke, right? Or a Darce choke, all right? Any questions with this? No one needs to see it again, we're good? We're cool, on three. One, two, three.